Game two of a three-game homestand for the Ducks and the Golden Knights, and their fans from Vegas have invaded Honda Center. Fourth and final meeting of the season between these two Pacific Division rivals. And Kessler trying to make a short little pass to Rowney, coughs it up. Here's John Merrill on the left hash mark. Chips it down low. Marchessault to Carlson, the first save of the game by Gibson is a good one. Grant to take the draw against Carlson, wins it back, but Rowney comes off the boards with it, and he got inside on Colin Miller. Rowney with a shot, big rebound off of Fleury, and it hopped the stick of Nick Ritchie, who nearly got to the carom.
Really don't get any opportunities anymore where you're coming down the wing with possession of the puck. Most of my chances, it's a quick pass. I got a split second to put it on the net.
Perry puts it on the net. It's juggled by Fleury. Sprong got there but couldn't convert the rebound.
You know, it's interesting, we're talking about that 0-3 draft. The Ducks really look out here.
Here's Stastny, and a big save by Gibson as he closed the door.
See how far the puck is ahead of Stastny right there? Well, most goaltenders will read that as what we call a five-hole push.
In his first two seasons, he's had at least 20 goals each year. Here's Alex Tuck, picks up a loose puck and muscles his way around Holzer, who may have gotten away with a little tug. Colin Miller can fire it. Gibson looks over his shoulder and gets the whistle. He had a goal and an assist last night in the win against the Panthers. Colin Miller now with a career-high 3 goals. Hard to believe he hasn't scored more than that. Back rebound for Fowler that he shoveled right through the crease. He had played 2 games with the Sabres at the time of the trade, and he told me this morning, he said, I was not anticipating being recalled by Buffalo this year. So you know, not only is there a lot of excitement when you go to a new organization, but he realizes this is a great opportunity. Henrique stabs the rebound of the point shot out of harm's way.
It's a bang bang play right on the doorstep. The rebound sat there for William Carlson. Watch the right leg of John Gibson. He boots it out just in the nick of time.
And a good job by Gouley, who picked him up. Knights possess again. Miller feeds it across. Hammered by Theodore, and that may have gone off a post after it hit Gibson.
Jakob Silverberg comes in, gets to the loose puck, and Silverberg rifles it right over top of the glass.
Quick puck movement, ricochets back to Theodore. Carlson left circle, finds Stone. His shot blocked. Boy, Kessler laid down in front of it. They get it right back to Stone, across for Carlson. He scores. Gibson moving to his left, unable to get back to his right, and that was a 4x6 for number 71.
Anytime the power play is able to move the puck this often through the interior of the 4-man penalty-killing box, it's trouble.
Carlson, who has the game's goal, keeps it moving along the boards. Marchessault shovels back for Riley Smith. Smith leaves it for Marchessault, wipes it back to Theodore, who gets it through, and it's gobbled up by Gibson. One of the real differences from a year ago when they won 22 times away from T-Mobile. Grant cuts in off the right side, and looking over his shoulder was Fleury.
The tuck of the arms in tight to the body for Fleury really takes away almost everything except the top corners of the net.
You mentioned when he first went to the OHL to play in his junior ranks, he went 11 or 12 games before he found the back of the net, and that would change. Here's Henrique, and he can't get a shot through as Fleury stays on his feet this time.
I think he put it right in the glove.
Silverberg hustles to the right side, gets it back, makes his way to the front of the net, poked away by Fleury, popped right to shore, and his shot turned away by the Vegas netminder. High slot, Raquel, and another save for Fleury. Rebound loose, Silverberg digs it free. Tried to turn it back through the mosh pit, and then got it again and fired it wide. He can curls with it, now takes it below the goal line. Still possesses one hand on the stick. Feeds it out to Merrill, across to Miller, who hammers it. And Gibson is there to hang on as it gets a little crowded down low. Belmar, high slot, deflected by Carpenter, who had Holzer all over him.
There's the touch over the shoulder of Gibson off the top of the crossbar.
Forced at the line by Megnin. Anaheim keeps it in. Raquel on the doorstep for Shore, and it ricocheted back to Silverberg, who couldn't get it on net. Shore was heading to the bench for a change. He played the puck to the corner as he lost the handle. Now he will change. Ducks able to get the puck back, though. Good work down low. Troy Terry steps in front, fires, stoned by Fleury, who covers up.
Oh, that that's a big stop for Marc-Andre Fleury. Good powerful move by Troy Terry, who walks out from behind the net, tries to pick that top corner. Marc-Andre Fleury gets a piece.
Shore got in the way, and now his cross-ice pass picked off by Sprong. Trying to find some space, and Theodore recovers on him. And his back behind the back backhand pass to no one is sent the other way. Here's Alex Tuck in, scores on the backhand. And that's how quick the Golden Knights can counter on you.
One move to the backhand, he shovels it between the wickets. And now a 2-0 lead for Vegas.
And now the Ducks deficit has been doubled. Eakin turns it over, Sprong steps in front, makes a pass off the post.
This one would have been huge for the Ducks.
Fleury, who moved to his left and made the stop. Tough shot for Jones, a left-hand shot. Comes to Grant in the slot. Good work by Terry and Jones below the goal line, and Fleury with another stop. I thought for 2 years he could lead the way. Now they're counting on five as Stone is turned away by Gibson. He tried to spring him while the Ducks were changing. Now Pacioretty on a give and go right down the slot. Goes wide. And throwing the right leg out was Gibson. Pacioretty just missed his shot.
Here's the opportunity for Pacioretty. Just loses possession at the moment of truth. They're going to continue to roll four lines here in short shifts.
Reeves in front, but the airborne pass didn't connect. Now he gets it again. And a good right pad save by Gibson.
Throws it up the middle, but active stick by Ryan Reeves. He gets the intercept and then a real quick shot. Good stop.
Because they don't give you any room. Riley Smith right on cue wins the puck out of the corner with Carlson. Theodore hammered it and a save by Gibson. Gooley recovers the rebound, but he's run off the puck there by Cody Eakin. Peary feeds the point. Cross ice pass off the mark and Schmidt hammers it. Peary put it right back into the crease where it's smothered by John Gibson. 8:45 left with a 2-goal lead on the road. Lindholm, nice pass. Opens some space for Raquel. Toe drags it around Merrill and can't stuff it underneath Fleury, and then Silverberg careens into the Vegas netminder with a little help from John Merrill.
Wonderful move around Merrill, and Jakob Silverberg tries to jam that rebound home.
Schmidt stretches it. Pacioretty behind the defense, cuts in, goes backhand, and Gibson got a piece of it.
Yeah, he got
penalty
chopped.
Coming up, I think Richie slashed him. And the Golden Knights possess again. Belmar to center, chips it ahead, racing after it, Cody Eakin. And he hits the empty net from a sharp angle with just 20 seconds remaining.
And it's Belmar, who's so responsible defensively, who just chips that into the open ice. And 2 feet above the goal line, Eakin finds the back of the net.
Here he plays it back to Fleury, and he'll have his 7th shutout of the season. Anaheim will be shut out for the 8th time this year.
Marc-Andre Fleury showed you why now he has 435 career National Hockey League wins.